G'day, I'm Justin from Black Opal Direct. Today I want to show you how to tumble opals, you know, using a barrel with a tumbler, and the barrel turns constantly for maybe even up to a couple of weeks at a time to get your opals smooth and polished. There's a few different special little techniques that you want to make sure you do in order to keep the opal safe and solid and in good condition. So let me show you how. So if we had rough opals like this, and we just put them straight into the barrel of the tumbler, it would take a very, very long time, maybe 2 or 3 weeks, for this to actually wear down to pebbles. And you'll still have sand spots in the stones, and they won't actually look that nice. So what we try to do is we take our rough pieces of opal, and we're going to grind it. Grind the edges, grind the sand off, and get it semi-smooth so that you get it to a pretty much a state like this, where you've ground it on the wheel, but you haven't polished it. So it's got nice smooth edges pretty much everywhere you're looking, and that is what you would put in the tumbler. So when you've got your pebbles in the tumbler, you want to make sure that when this barrel turns, you can see it turns on the machine. These opals are going to crush and bang and clang inside together. They're going to knock each other around, and they will get chips, they will get breaks and stuff like that if you do that a lot. So what I use, and a lot of people do use, is these plastic pellets. You put these plastic pellets inside the barrel, and you fill it up quite a fair bit, and the rule of thumb is you fill your barrel up about a third. So you've got 2/3 of water and air, and 1/3 is the opal and your other compounds. So this plastic stuff, when it goes in there and these opals are tumbling around, they're grinding still with the grinding powder that's in there, but the actual, when a stone falls down and hits another stone, usually those plastic pebbles will stop it from actually smacking into each other, so they don't break or shatter or anything like that, which is really important when you want a high polish. So every couple of days, or every day, you really want to check your opal to make sure it's not being worn away. It's really important, because you could have a really nice piece in there and come back 2 days later and actually where the colour was really nice has gone because you've worn it away. So you've got to be really careful about that. So check it every single day. Once you get a nice smooth effect from the first compound that you put in there, the quite rough compound, you want to take it to the next compound down. So what you've got to do is you've got to clean your barrel out really well, give it a good wash and a wipe up, and then you can put your stones back in there and your new compound and some fresh water. And also, you want to use, you can wash your plastic beads again and use them again, but I just, because they're cheap, I actually just buy a packet and I chuck it out when it's done, and then I start again with some fresh ones. It's always the best way, because impurities make scratches in stones, especially when you're coming from a rough to a finer polish. Always happens, you'll get scratches and it doesn't give as good an effect. So once we've done that rough one, we've got our stone to a nice smooth effect, we'll go to the next step, which will be a pumice or a finer pumice. There's two different courses of pumice that I use, and one's a really coarse grade pumice, and then you've got a finer pumice, which is almost a polish. So you put the finer pumice in and leave it there, and that could take up to 2 to 3 days to polish your pieces, depending on how many you have in the barrel and depending on how much water you have in the barrel. Don't have too much water in the barrel, because you don't want the stones to be floating around in the water. You want them to actually be grinding and banging as they're turning over, because that grinding effect is what gives the polish on the stones. So make sure it's more of a paste, or just a dry, like not dry, but a bit of a liquid in there, just to give it that grinding effect. If you have it not enough, or you have not enough plastic beads in there, you'll find that your stones will start to craze, get banged and chipped and stuff like that. So have a practice with it on some really cheap opal to begin with, or some stuff that you really don't see any value in. And then once you've done that, you get to know it a little bit better. It takes practice, and you will learn each different type of tumbling machine is a different size, so you're going to have different quantities as well. So have a play with it and see how you go. But once you've finished your polishing, your stone should look like this. So you can go from this to this. And that's the whole idea about tumbling opals, is to get that nice pebble polish. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions, give me an email. And if you're interested in buying any opal, you can have a look on my website. Thanks for watching.